expected to have dinner, but you know, since the number is too big, Sister Mahasin, where are you? She's over there. She's going to ask a couple of tables at a time to go get their food to avoid standing in line. I'm going to entertain you while these couple of tables get in line. Sister Mahasin, go ahead and ask some tables, the tables that you want them to eat. Since you are waiting anyway, I would like to tell you something and share something with you. Sister, you know, hopefully try to avoid these people when they are talking about in the back. Going back, talking about women in Islam, you know, there's lots of misconception between tradition and the religion itself. I would like just to clarify the place value of women in Islam. Starting with women or females in her parents' house when she's little, at that era, before Islam came, the teaching of Islam, people, you know, having a female in the house, it was a sign of shame. So that, you know, when somebody get a daughter, that was a shame thing to have. So when Islam came, they changed the idea of receiving this girl. It established a better relationship between parents, father, and daughter. So one of the teaching of Islam that Islam taught us and the Prophet emphasized on that girls supposed to be treated and, you know, caring, loving, respecting, giving her what she needs. To emphasize that point, our Prophet, he said, and the Quran said that, the same thing. So the Prophet is confirming what the Quran said. He told his people and he told them that whoever have a daughter and treated her good, providing her the food, providing her with a good education, the faith that can she protect herself, so this person will enter heaven. That changed the concept of people. These people would like to please God. So their treatment, their thought of their daughter being having a female in the house changed. You know, this is when she's young. Thinking about this daughter when she's getting older, you know, in the age of marriage, at that time, the culture was really closed. You know, there was arranged marriage that was popular, but guess what? It's up to the girl to accept the man who's coming to marry her or not. So even the imam who is making the blessings or making this marriage happen, he has to listen to that girl. And you know what she's saying? Yes, I accept that man as my husband. If he didn't hear that word from her, even if the father wants to get her married, that man, that marriage will not be processed. It will be stopped. This is as a girl. Which now, in case she accepted the marriage, there's another thing. We are valued, but there's misconceptions. Now, when we are accepted the marriage, for example, we receive money. That money is given to the girl. This is as a gift. Some people, they think they have misunderstand the idea and they say, oh, dad is selling his daughter. That's not selling because the money, it doesn't go to the dad's pocket. It goes to the girl pocket and she can buy whatever she wants. She can buy gold. It depends on how much he gives her. So it depends on the financial situation too of the guy. Now, one more thing. They're still eating, so it's not your turn yet. See, I'm occupying you over here. So one more thing. When she gets married in her husband's house, for example, let's see what happens. For example, if I'm working and I have money from my parents, I'm not talking about myself. I'm not actually obligated to pay a single money to my husband, who just came right now, unless if I want to. My religion tells me the money is for me, it's for myself. I'm not obligated to share. But to strengthen the family bonds, she's encouraged to share the expenses, the house expenses with the house. But guess what? In this case, since she's not obligated, it's considered as charity. So she will be rewarded for spending that money on her husband and her kids. Now, thinking about, you know, furthermore, thinking about Sharia law, what's about Sharia law? Each man, he gets an inheritance twice as much as a female. Some people, they say, oh, that is not fair. my brother, he's going to get twice as much as me. Why not me? I have kids, I have husband. But guess what? There is a reason behind every law in our religion. But we have to know, we have to search. What is the reason for the boy or the male to get as twice as much as a female? First of all, because in religion, as a female, I'm not obligated. If my parents are poor, or my brother or sister are poor, I'm not obligated to pay money for them. It's my brother obligations. Because normally, you know, we ask for women like being equivalent with men and equal to men, but let's admit that. What type of work that men can do, women can do. I can't be, you know, there's my physical posture, my physical strength doesn't allow me to do what the man can do. So that's why, in case I'm in really bad pain and I need money, I can't go work any type of work. Even the lowest paid work, it's not going to help me supporting my family. But the husband, normally, there's better chances for them. Maybe they are more educated. It happens. Doesn't mean that women are not educated. No. Sometimes women can be educated as much as husbands or even more. But that's why, you know, the man, he has the responsibility for